sharings of some of you, including today's gospel, remind me of that experience I had in Jerusalem, in the Holy Land. If we go to Jerusalem today, somewhere above the Mount of Olives is this beautiful chapel. The name of the chapel is Dominus Flevit. Dominus Flevit in Latin means the Lord wept. Dominus or Domino means Lord, and Flevit means weep or cry. Hindi lang iyak kung hindi agulhul. And it's built on that area, in that place where we Christians traditionally believe that more than 2,000 years ago, the Lord, overlooking the walled city of Jerusalem, started to cry. And he said the following, "O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how long have I yearned? How long have I desired to gather you, like a mother hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but you rejected me." The whole chapel is shaped like a gigantic teardrop, parang isang napakalaking lupa. And the architect, Antonio Berluzzi, an Italian architect, in 1955, shaped it in the way he shaped it, precisely like a teardrop, to show precisely the vulnerability of our God. My dear friends, in the sharing, no? A few times, or at least several times, what I mentioned yesterday, no? The link, the inevitable link between vulnerability on the one hand and loving on the other hand. The two are inseparable. If we choose to love, we cannot but experience some quality of vulnerability. And the more we choose to love, the more we open ourselves to very, very vulnerable feelings and vulnerable situations. I remember a couple I was counseling, especially the lady, the woman, talagang grabe, no? Umiinom yung lalaki a few times, unfaithful, minsan sinusuntok siya. All the problems are there. So at one point, I asked her, why do you decide to stay with him? Then she said, "I think because I love him." Sabi ko, "You think?" "No, I don't think. I believe I love him." "You believe?" "No, I feel I love him." "You feel?" "No, I choose to love him." Because in the end, loving is not just a feeling. It's a choice. I choose to love even if I don't feel like loving this person. It's like forgiveness. I choose to forgive even if I don't feel like forgiving. And that's why when we choose to love, we choose to be vulnerable, and when we choose to be vulnerable, the tears will come. And in spirituality, particularly in Christian spirituality, many spiritual writers have coined the expression, "gift of tears." Ano ibig sabihin ng gift of tears? Monks, embracing monastic spirituality, even Jesuits embracing apostolic spirituality, will tell us when tears come out of our eyes, that can be a sign of God's gift. And of course, when tears flow, we become all the more vulnerable. Sabi nga nila, eye doctors will tell us that when we shed tears, it clears our eyes. It purifies our eyes. And that's why once in a while, it's good to to shed tears. It's good to cry. It's good to be vulnerable. Because when we are vulnerable, we begin to see so many other realities which we will never see unless we choose to be vulnerable and we choose to love. And I believe this is part of today's gospel. I am the true vine. Remain in me as I remain in you. But it does not stop there. Our Lord talks about pruning. The Lord tells us, I have to prune you. Everyone that does bear fruit, He prunes so that it bears more fruit. So the more He prunes us, the more we will bear fruit. And of course, who desires to be pruned? Kasi masakit. And yet again, that's so much part of loving. That is so much part of being vulnerable. And that is the pattern of the Paschal Mystery. Ano ba ang Paschal Mystery? The dying and the rising. No dying, no rising. No pruning, no bearing fruit. No Good Friday, no Easter Sunday. No desolation, no consolation. No pain, no gain. That's the pattern. No emptying, no being filled up. In Greek, they use the term kenosis, to empty. We have to go through the kenosis, emptying ourselves. If we do not empty ourselves, then we will never fill up the pleroma experience. And then I believe the community, your community, is going through that, going through much pruning. But I believe the fruits are already there. We only have to wait for some time. 3 years is very, very short. What is 3 years? And yet, look at you now. It's bearing fruit. But as we continue to bear fruit, the pruning continues. And many of us do not want to be pruned. Who likes to be pruned? But there is no other way. But if we love, if we choose to love, then pruning will not be so painful. That's why the best way to handle pruning is by choosing to love. And that's why we were saying, unless we love, unless we love the Lord, and unless we love this community, the Acts community, again, everything will just be an added task, an added burden. And who wants additional burden, additional task? No one. But if you choose to love, choosing to be vulnerable, okay, love, love it, kasi mahal ko eh, mamahal ako, then everything begins to be light. A little easy. Of course, the struggle will be there still, but not as heavy as when we do not choose to love. I remember that day I was cleaning my room. I rarely clean my room. That day I decided to clean my room. Then I saw that box filled with letters of my mother. So sumusulat siya sa akin, especially when I left home, sa seminaryo ako, and when I lived abroad. I lived for 2 years in Korea, at least 3 years in Mindanao, wala ako dito. 2 years, almost 2 years and a half in America, then 4 years in London. So when wala ako dito sa Pilipinas, she would write to me. And she would write very long letters, yellow pad pa yan, ha? Tsaka hindi computer, kasi at that time, wala nang computer, talaga long hand. Sabi ko, and I was reminded of that. So imagine if my mother would consider writing to me as a task. Ano kaya nangyari sa akin? No, everything is light. Bakit? Kasi nagmamahal. pagmamahal ng isang inang. And that's why when we choose to love, everything becomes lighter. It's no longer a burden. But still, we become vulnerable. So I believe this 2 days, isipin yung 2 days lang, ang dami na nangyari. And I myself was surprised because I did not know what to expect in these 2 days. And yet, it has begun to bear fruit. So we need to collect all these fruits and to recognize the fact that we will not continue to bear fruit unless we allow ourselves to be pruned, unless we enter into the Paschal mystery pattern. And that's part of the commitment. That's part of saying yes to the Lord. When we say yes to the Lord, we're saying, yes, I'm willing to submit myself to the Paschal mystery pattern. Again, what is the Paschal mystery pattern? No pruning, no fruit. No emptying, no filling up. No Good Friday, no Easter Sunday, and so on. No dying, no rising. And that's the only way. So in this Mass, I hope we realize that. And so many beautiful realizations. I was so touched by the shavings, no? That are coming from the heart. I think you need to do this all the more. Opening our communication lines and reaching out to one another. And the beautiful experience here is that we have been brought closer to the Lord. And I think the Acts community is indeed an instrument. You are an instrument of the Lord. An instrument that can bring people much closer to the Lord. And again, it's not all about accomplishments or successes. It's all about faithfulness. How do you measure the writing of my mother of all those letters in terms of success? Can you measure that in terms of success? It's in terms of fidelity. You just kept on writing, even though sometimes I would not write back. Pero sige na, pagmamahal ng isang ina. Kung ganyan katindi ang pagmamahal ng isang ina, ano pa kaya ang gusto? Today is First Saturday. And the whole month of May is dedicated, consecrated to our Lady. Yeah, May, in the month of May, which is Marian month. Kaya ang daming pag-aalay. You go around the different parishes all over the Philippines. Ang daming alayan, alay kay Maria, mga hulak-hulak. Usually afternoons in different parishes all over the Philippines. Flowers brought by children particularly, and even some adults to Our Lady, the love of a mother. And you take that love and even consider the love of Jesus. In this Mass, let us pray for ourselves to commit the willingness to say yes. Yes, I'm willing to submit myself to this Paschal mystery pattern, and I do it all in the name of vulnerability. Yes, all in the name of love. Amen. Let us now all stand and pray the prayer.